that you made my deceased mother very happy. She's looking down from heaven. Not that it matters in any regard to you, but they named North Washington Avenue, where I was raised as a kid in Scranton, 2446, right across the street. They named it Joe Biden Way. And so those important things are important things, okay? I just want to say, Paige, thank you so much for doing that. I appreciate it. Folks, look, I want to thank you, the elected leadership of the conference. They're great officials in Louisville, and Mary Nan Whaley of Dayton. And I'm watching their stories on television so much, I feel like we're hanging out together, Mary. Thank you for doing this. I want to thank all the folks for joining us, for everything you're doing to keep your residents and communities safe during this pandemic. And I want to take a moment to acknowledge, as I said, my hometown here, but I also want to personally thank you all for doing what you're doing to keep us safe, not only in Delaware, but around the country. All of you have are on the front lines from the very beginning, and as we head into this Thanksgiving, in a very dark winter of cases of hospitalizations and death spiking, I want you to know that we're here for you, and we're going to listen to you and work with you. And it's the first priority we're going to have once sworn in. This is our message to a bipartisan group of governors, the National Governors Association. We have the same message, and we want to remember a few days ago, and no matter which party, whether you're political, whether you're Democrat or Republican, there is a strong sense of common purpose, a real desire for a real partnership between the states, the cities, and the federal government. And there's a strong consensus that we have to move forward in a coordinated way among the governors on delivering the economic relief to cities, states, and tribal communities sooner rather than later, and with greater flexibility to allow you to shore up your budgets and meet your needs. If that was true for the governors, I can't believe it's not true for all of you. On the safe, equitable, and free distribution of vaccines, which will be one of the greatest operational challenges we're going to face. I'm implementing what works, including universal masking and expanded testing. And I'm building back better so we can beat the pandemic, investing in public health and infrastructure, early education, strengthening the Buy American requirements and American manufacturing. And I know there are so many other issues that your cities are on the front lines of: racial justice, climate change, paid family leave, minimum wage, closing broadband gaps, ending homelessness. All of this is, I mean, you deal with it every single day, every single minute. But the only way to meet these challenges, I believe, and so does Kamala, that we have to come together as a nation. You mayors get it. You know, I've had the privilege of speaking at the conference of mayors many, many times. And I've always had enormous respect for just how tough your jobs are and need to serve. So much respect. When I first got elected, I was a councilman. And after 2 years when they reapportioned me, I decided to run for the Senate. It was too hard to be a local official. Everybody knows what you did. The quality of lives falls on your shoulders. You know, making sure people feel safe walking down the street, making sure the garbage gets picked up, all the concrete things that can make or break a citizen's day. But, you know, the partisan things, there are partisan things, but the practical things are what we have to deal with. People look to you, and that's why I made it a priority to work closely with the mayors from the time I was a councilman, U.S. Senator, and my 10 years vice president. And it will be a priority for me as president. When President Obama gave me the honor of leading the Recovery Act, which was about 80, turned out to be about $84 billion. The first thing I did was go to the mayor. Some of you may remember this. That's how I heard it. I literally picked the phone. I spoke with over 200 mayors personally, Democrats, Republicans, and a few independents, to get the stimulus funding out and invested in the cities all across the country. It took time for the work like hell to get it done. We worked together. We got it done, Democrat and Republican. Because of you, our mayors, we came through that crisis together. It's the same approach that the Vice President and I are going to have as we come and we once over and take over in January. Today is not a one-off meeting. It's just a start. I promise you, the Biden-Harris administration will have an open door for mayors. Our team is fully available to you. already heard from Julie Chavez and Rodriguez earlier, who's going to be leading in the government affairs in the White House. You may not even know her. You may not even know her well. And she will be the point person with a clear mission. Blue cities, red cities, it doesn't matter. They're all American cities, American communities. We deserve the full support of an American president. I promise you that. Every mayor deserves a president who is going to be a true partner. And the bottom line is, we can't do this without you. This country is built from the bottom up. There's nothing beyond our capacity. We just have to come together as a country. And I mean that from the bottom of my heart. I know when I said that, when I announced for president almost 500 some days ago, I said I wanted to unify the country. Well, I mean it. We mean it. I hope you are prepared to do that as well. So I want to thank you all again. And now I'd like to turn this over to Mayor Fisher and look forward to some discussion. Mayor?
All right. Thank you so much.